I got a chance to spend the day with Whitney Inman, who is a guide with the Angler's Edge. She guides on the East Walker River up there in Eastern California, Nevada. And we were there on the East Walker, and she kind of walked me through a run there in that on that river to give me some detail and just give some idea of her tactics and understanding. I love to kind of go through reading and understanding water and hopefully be able to pick up a little bit, some tips to use in your own techniques and strategies when you're fishing your waters.
So looking at this section of river here, we have a little bit of current coming off of the left and a little slight amount of current coming off of the right and a little bit of just very flat, calm water in the middle. You can see the shadow here also on our river right, where this little bit of fast water is. I would start here, target that, move my way across, see if anything might be holding in the middle. The faster water might be better for maybe what we'd call like a short leash setup. So it's a little foam indicator with your nymphs below it, or you could set up a dry dropper setup so you've got, you know, two hooks on the water. Maybe something comes up and says, I want to eat that dry instead. It looks, you know, like a big meal. We're coming out of winter into springtime. Maybe it might get someone's attention down here. Or just that it might, they may see that fly hit the water, go, oh, there's a big food source, but that's not really the time of year for that. But they see that nymph below it. That's more of what they're keyed in on at this time of year. But that little dry fly will act as an indicator for you, which is always kind of handy. And you never know, something may just go, huh, it's a big snack, I want it. Where I would avoid is this little pool that's real shallow and slack. There's a sandpiper hanging out over here by it. That little area, I wouldn't necessarily target anything there. Again, if I'm not seeing something actively feeding there, that tells me they're, you know, either they're sunning, or if they're even there, they may not be. But that's kind of water I would leave alone. I would focus more on where I see the cut bank that tells me there's a little deeper channel here that in all likelihood they're gonna be holding in that deeper water.
Fly fishing is so cool. You can just learn tons of stuff all the time that you didn't even realize, picking up little bits here and there, and hopefully you picked up a little bit there from Whitney Inman. She's with the Angler's Edge. Let us know. We'll put you in contact with her if you're looking for somebody to guide up on the East Walker River. She is very knowledgeable of that area. Those are her home waters, and she knows every bit of the Miracle Mile as well as the various sections of the East Walker. Let us know. We'll put you in touch with Whitney. We'll see you right here next time on the Backcast.